Just shoot for the stars if it feels right.
Hi, honeybees. Today is kind of a serious topic. I know a lot of you are like, where the heck have you been? So many of you have been sending me Twitter messages and on Instagram and Snapchat and here on YouTube, and a lot of you now know what happened. But today I'm here to explain what happened to me, why I disappeared off YouTube for a few weeks, and why I have this fancy cast right here. Pink and sparkles, of course. And I'm just gonna go over pretty much everything that happened. So, because I know so many of you are interested and have been asking me about it, and I've been really trying to be good about updating you guys on Twitter and Snapchat. Those are the two main places that I have been making sure to update. Instagram, I have been completely absent. It's really hard to take an Instagram picture when you're like this and not really mobile, and I'll go into that in a second. So I haven't really been able to update on there. So if you don't follow me, I have all my social media linked down below. Make sure to do that. All right, so please obviously excuse, I'm very minimal makeup here. Mama B actually helped straighten my hair for me today, and I don't have any jewelry or anything on because it's a minimalistic life right now because I'm just trying to get better. Okay, so let's start off from the beginning. I was doing Vlogmas, and I was having so much fun doing Vlogmas for you guys. I'll definitely do it again next year. And I was just driving home from baking, and if you just watched my last vlog, you'll see what I was baking. I was driving home from my parents, and I got in a car accident, and I got in a very severe car accident. Now, I can't go into details regarding the car accident because we do have, you know, some stuff going on with my lawyer and my insurance, so I don't want to go into too much detail where it would interfere with our case, but just know that it was very severe and my car was totaled. I don't remember anything from the accident, which is so weird, and at first I was really upset that I didn't remember anything because I'm such a control freak, but now I think it's actually better that I forgot because the trauma of it would probably be pretty severe where I probably wouldn't ever drive again, so I'm actually kind of thankful that I don't remember. All I do know is that I did have to be extracted from the car, from the fire department, and some really nice woman saw the accident or saw the after effect of it and came to my car and asked me for my parents' phone number. So that was really great because I was coherent enough to give her my parents' phone number. My mom and dad did rush to the accident and were there for the majority of like me getting out of the car and into the emergency vehicle, into the ambulance, and I was rushed to the ER. And there, I don't remember much of anything. What I do remember is waking up in the ER, and I don't know if he was the doctor or nurse, whatever he was, told me that we're gonna have to cut off your clothes now, ma'am, is that okay? And I'm pretty sure I was just like, yeah, whatever, you know, like, I just had some comfy, like, yoga pants on, and my ballerina Crocs that I'm obsessed with. I'm really upset about that, losing those, so I'm gonna have to repurchase them for sure. And like I had a kind of like a comfy cozy PJ top on, so apparently they did have to cut my clothes off of me, and my tibia, like the smaller bone in your leg, not the femur but the smaller one, had to be reset. Thankfully I don't remember any of that either because I'm sure that would have been real painful. So they had to reset that, and my ankle was completely pretty much shattered, the bones in my ankle, to the point where they had to perform surgery later on my hospital visit. So they just wrapped it and everything, and I'll go into that in a second. So finally, after hours and hours, probably poor Mama B having to endure that all night long, I think it was like 4 a.m. before I got to an actual hospital room, and around that time is when I became coherent again and like awake enough to remember things. And of course my first question I asked, you guys are gonna laugh, not even caring about myself and like all the pain I'm enduring, the first thing I asked was, is my computer okay and is my vlogging camera okay? Because I had just come from my parents' house where I had all my stuff in the back of the car, and I was very lucky, all my electronics made it safe. Not so much me, but the electronics were fine. And I also, I haven't told Mama B this, but I was concerned about my new peach peach lip gloss that was in my purse, but that made it too from Too Faced, the new peach lip gloss, because that's how much I love them. I was concerned about it, but anyways, so then they told me what happened. Of course, I didn't remember anything, so they had to tell me all of the details and what happened, and of course I had a million questions, and I was kind of emotional and crying because I didn't know what was going to happen, and it was hard, but they had me on the good stuff then. I had the straight IV of meds, so I was just knocking right out, sleeping like a little baby. It was wonderful then. So then the next day I had my first surgery. No, I think it was the next day, or it might have been the day after that. I had my first surgery for my ankle. So it's my left ankle. I now am in a boot, but initially I was in kind of like a cast kind of thing. But they did surgery on my ankle, and I now have, I think it's 4 plates in my ankle, my left ankle, with screws and all that fun jazzy stuff. And then I also hurt my hand quite a bit. So we thought these 3 fingers were affected. Turns out this finger isn't broken or anything, so now I'm really just trying to do a lot of physical therapy on it to try to get it to move like this. It doesn't. It wants to just move about there. So, still working on that. But this finger, I have a fracture on the tip of the finger, and it looked horrible. It was like bright purple at the tip. This might get a little... I'm getting into the details now, so if you get a little grossed out, then maybe you don't want to listen to this part and fast forward a little. But the doctor that performed my ankle surgery, who I love, he's an amazing doctor. He's so nice. He's awesome. He also had to drain the blood out of this top of the finger, and then my nail came off completely, so they had to repair my nail bed. I am, one of the things that I'm most concerned about having come back to normal is this nail. I do not want to have a missing nail for the rest of my life, so I trust him. So I really hope that this nail grows back and that everything's okay with it, but that's why I have this little contraption on it to hold it in place. And then my thumb, the next day, I had a second surgery for these 2 fingers, but I guess it's really only my thumb that he performed the surgery on. I guess I just have soft tissue damage on this finger, so they did have it wrapped up like as if it was broken, but it's not. The thumb, I have a really gruesome incision all the way down my thumb because I pretty much crushed the bone again there. I must have been holding on to that steering wheel for dear life with my right hand. I'm so lucky that my left hand is all good. See, this arm is all good, and I'm left-handed if you didn't know. So that has been a really nice thing to have still. That's a blessing. So the thumb, because the bone was pretty much shattered, they had to put a plate in my thumb also, and it's big. I saw an x-ray the other day, and maybe I'll insert things at the end just in case people don't want to see the gruesome stuff in x-rays. I'll have that maybe at the end if you're interested in seeing it, but there are screws everywhere in my thumb. And he said that I'll probably have arthritis or problems with it, or it's a possibility that I'll have it. Which, if there's a possibility, that means I'm getting it. Let's be real. So, I just went to his office last week after getting out of rehab, and that's when I got the cast put on, and I'll probably have this for about 2 weeks. That's when my next appointment is. Really hoping I get this thing off, because it's cute, but it's annoying to have. So, I also have a pelvic fracture on my left side. So, that's... The whole left side is what caused me the most pain and discomfort, especially in the beginning. I could not move. Like, I was just like, felt like a mummy in a bed. Like, I couldn't move without someone helping me move my leg, adjust my body, pull me up into a bed, like, so that I could sit up. There was just no movement possible, and it was so frustrating and so painful, and I had, like, I couldn't get up to go to the bathroom, like I had a catheter. I don't remember that being put in. Don't ask me about that. I must have been really drugged up, thank God, because a lot of people ask me, like, was that painful? I'm like, I don't remember. I don't think, it probably was painful, but compared to the pain that I had with everything else, it was nothing. So yeah, I don't remember that. So I was at the hospital for 9 days. And it felt like a month, let me just tell you. And I got in the accident on the 20th at night. So I did end up missing Christmas, Christmas Eve, New Year's Eve, my stepdad's birthday, because he was born on New Year's Eve. So that was just really depressing, and I tried to just take it day by day and not think about it too much, because if I did end up thinking about it too much, I would get anxiety and feel really depressed and just start bawling my eyes out, and that did nothing for me. And to this day, I still have moments where I get really, really frustrated and just feel so, I have no control over anything, and that's what makes me so frustrated, that I just can't do what I want to do. But thank God for Mama B, because she does help me so much in doing these things. But that's when I start getting really upset and depressed. But then I just have to bring myself back and be like, okay, just take it step by step, Melissa. And that's just really hard for me to do, because I'm not that kind of a person. I'm a planner. I think ahead all the time for things. So it's really hard for me to just stay in this moment of just recover, just take this one step. So yeah, like I said, I was in the hospital for quite a long time. Oh, I forgot to say this one thing. So after my second surgery, the doctor ended up rushing me to the emergency room because he wasn't happy with how I was breathing, like my respiration. And ends up I had a PE, which is a pulmonary embolism, and that's extremely serious. If you don't know what that is, definitely look it up. It's crazy. I definitely had a guardian angel with me, or just God was with me and helped me through all that. But that was pretty much the most traumatic thing that happened to me, even after all this, I know. But that was the most traumatic because they made me wake up with a breathing tube down my throat. Yeah. I hope to God that none of you have to ever have that happen to you, because they made me have it down my throat for 30 minutes as I'm awake, and I was freaking out. I didn't like it whatsoever. I couldn't talk, like I couldn't say anything, and it also felt like I couldn't breathe properly. It felt like something was lodged, like saliva, so it was rattling when I was trying to breathe, so it just made it even worse of an experience. And I actually was spelling things out, like on my like leg to my mama, and I spelled O-U-T, O-U-T, like over and over to tell her to like, get this out of me, which is like, we can't, honey, we can't, like, just listen to them, just keep breathing. And they kept telling me, breathe, breathe. I'm like, I am breathing, or I'm trying to, but I can't because this saliva thing is like clogging my throat. It was horrible, so horrible. And they did like scans on my legs to make sure I didn't have blood clots anywhere else, because essentially it was a blood clot in my lung that they had to get removed. So horrible. And then finally, when they were like, okay, we're gonna take it out, I was like, thank you, Jesus. Like, the whole time I was just like praying, like, please just get this out of me, God, as fast as possible. And I was just trying to stay calm, but it was really hard to. And then finally they're like, oh, it might hurt. In my head, I was like, who the freak cares? Just get it out. Like, nothing could be worse than this being in my throat right now. It didn't hurt. In my opinion, it didn't really hurt. They just made me take a deep breath and they took it right out. It wasn't that big of a deal in comparison of it being in my body. So yeah, that was definitely the worst experience, and I hope I never have to deal with anything like that ever again, because it was miserable. So, and now I have to be on a blood thinner because of the PE. I'm really upset about that. I have to be on it for 6 months. So that's pretty frustrating. I just don't like taking medicine, like medications, and now I have to be on another medication. Because as most of you already know, I have low producing thyroid, so I have to be on thyroid medicine too. So yeah, I can't believe I forgot to say that in the beginning, so. So now it's been almost a month. I think it's been exactly a month, actually. It's been a month. After spending 9 days in the hospital, I finally was moved to a rehab facility, like a rehabilitation facility, where I did physical therapy and occupational therapy for 3 to 4 hours a day. And they broke it up into different segments. It was a really nice facility. I have no complaints about where I was placed. I felt very blessed to be there, because there were other places they were looking into prior to that that were not as nice. And I didn't care, though. I just was like, get me out of this hospital. I'll go to that facility if that's what it takes for me to get out of this hospital. But definitely from all your prayers, I know it's from all your prayers and from all my friends and family praying and really giving that positive energy. I really believe that's how I was able to get to this other facility. And literally, me and my brother and my mom were together in my hospital room when they came in to tell us that I was accepted into that facility. And we all were just so, so happy and like tears and just so happy. So I spent a little over a week at the rehabilitation center. And once I started getting up out of bed, which was about, I think, 4 or 5 days of being in the hospital, right after the PE in intensive care, they were like, yeah, you can't have a catheter anymore. You need to start going to the bathroom on your own. And of course, I was completely panicked because I knew how much pain I was going to be in trying to get up to go to the bathroom. And I had like a bedside commode kind of thing, TMI possibly, but yeah, that's what happened. Because I couldn't make it to the actual bathroom. So that first time that they had to get me up to go to the bathroom, oh my Lord, I can't even explain that pain to you guys. And that's on pain medication. Oh, and then yeah, that's another thing I should mention. After I had the PE, no more IV medications for Melissa. No more good drugs for me. I had to just be on pill form, which you know that when you get a pill form, it's not going to be instant gratification. Like, it takes 15, 20 minutes before you feel the effects of the pain pills. So, and they weren't very high doses either. They were, you know, minimal doses. I don't know why I couldn't have IV after that. I guess it would mess with my respirations. So that was pretty killer too, to have to feel a lot more of the pain, and it was really hard to go to sleep. To this day, it's still really hard for me to go to sleep, because I'm a side sleeper. I sleep on my side, and right now I have to sleep on my back. My foot has to be, you know, up, raised up, and flat. Like, it can't go to the side. It has to be up straight. So my right leg, I can move that, like, you know, up and down, around, but that doesn't really do much for me. So I kind of sleep like straight, but like with my neck to the side, because I just can't sleep up straight like this. And I just wake up all the time with crooks in my neck and my back's hurting. Like, pretty much it's been crazy and a little bit miserable, but I'm just really happy and blessed to be here and to be able to start filming again for you guys, thanks to Mama B helping me. And just thanks to all of your prayers, your good thoughts, all your comments. I've been reading every single one of them. Even when I was in the hospital, I was reading them all on Twitter and seeing them on Snapchat. I'm really sorry if I didn't respond to you. It's going to be really tough for me to respond with just having my one hand and typing. I rather take my time to edit this video, try to make more content, and think about new and fresh ideas for when I am able-bodied and completely mobile on my own. So yeah, once I was out of the rehabilitation center, it was like victory. I was so excited to go home because it's just really hard being somewhere without your family and being somewhere alone and having nurses having to take care of you hand and foot. And I mean, I know that's what they're there for, but it's just depressing. And I met some really great, sweet people there, though, that I did really like, and my family did come and have dinner and lunch with me, and my stepdad would come in the morning before work and have breakfast with me sometimes. And thank goodness the food at the rehabilitation center was bomb. It was so good. At the hospital I was at was horrible. The food was disgusting. So it was really nice to have, like, to finally feel like I could eat again. I really didn't eat very much for the first 9 days of this happening to me. So after being at the rehabilitation center, I was able to start moving a little bit more. Like, my hip, where my pelvic fracture is, it's still really sore. It's still really hard to move around, but it's heaps and bounds better than it was initially. I'm able to get up into bed. I'm able to kind of maneuver a little bit more. It definitely took time, but I'm to that point where it's much better. and I'm slowly getting off the pain pills. I still probably take one or two a day. I'm really trying to get completely off of them because they do mess with your body, and they're messing with some stuff for me, and I really just want to be off them completely. But I also don't want to be in excruciating pain, so it's kind of like trying to have a little bit of a balance. And right now, I'll try and take a picture of the walker that I use. They had to put this little extension on the right side so that I can put weight into my right elbow and forearm and my left hand to hop and be able to move. It's very difficult on my right knee. I'm starting to have problems with my right knee now. It's hurting so much because all the weight is on that knee. But I am able to maneuver, and as I went through physical therapy, I was able to get more and more, like stamina and mobility with that. Initially, I couldn't even lift my right leg. I was just scooting my foot. I couldn't even hop. So I am definitely big improvements there. And then I'm sitting right now, I don't know if you can see, like I am in a wheelchair, and I probably will be using this wheelchair to get around for the most part for the next 2 months, maybe. I'm hoping that I'm going to be better before then, but the estimated total of me getting mobile again was 12 weeks, and right now it's been a month, so I still have a long journey ahead of recovery, and you guys will be seeing it because I'm going to be vlogging again, so you'll see me doing what I gotta do, and I'll have more physical therapy coming up as my injuries progress. Like, once this is off, I'm gonna need physical therapy for my thumb to get it mobile again. Same thing with my ankle. I'm not gonna be able to walk on it initially. It's gonna take some time. I just can't wait to be myself again and to be back to normal and be able to shower myself, walk to the bathroom myself, you know, straighten my hair. I can do my makeup still, guys, because I got my left hand, so that's still okay. Can't do a cat eye, though. One-handed, that's a little hard. But I literally can't do much on my own. And I'm a very independent person, so that is probably the biggest thing for me, is I just want to be on my own again and stable on my own. But like I said before, I'm very, very thankful for everyone that's been helping me, especially Mom V, because she's pretty much been my nurse. So yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. I hope that you guys got kind of a better idea of what's been going on with me. If you have questions though, feel free to ask them down below. Like I said, there might be questions that I can't answer regarding the accident because that can interfere with our case and my insurance, and that's something I'm not going to mess up right now. So if you have questions like, where did it happen, and who hit you, and what, you know, all that kind of stuff, I can't answer that. So please don't ask that down below. But if you have questions regarding my injuries or what kind of physical therapy I'm doing or anything like that, I'd be more than happy to try to answer those for you as quickly as I can. And I hope this was helpful. I will do another video once our case is done, and once everything is done, I can do a more detailed account of what happened with the accident, but just for right now, that's all I can say. And I hope you guys like this. Again, thank you so much. I can't even say thank you enough for all the comments. I read every single one. I honestly almost started crying yesterday reading all the comments on the vlog, because you guys have just been so caring and loving and praying for me and giving me good vibes and just wishing me well. That means so much to me. I have the most amazing subscribers, and I know so many YouTubers say that, but I really, really do have the best subscribers. I think even someone commented somewhere because they noticed all the love and all the prayers, and they even said, "Melissa, you have the best subscribers." I'm like, I know, I do. You guys, we are literally a family here, and I just really, really appreciate everything that you are putting out there in the universe for me, and I will keep you updated, like I said, on social media and also in the vlogs. I love you so much, and I'll see you again real soon. Bye.